as a quick overview for those of you who are weren't here this morning, we received a call at approximately 12:40 of a boat on fire at this marina, Jackson County Park Marina, Dock B. On arrival, that dock appeared to be about 30% involved. That fire, because of its location on the inward side of the dock, on the inland side rather, caused substantial access problems for firefighters to get to the fire, and at the same time, egress problems for occupants of that boat dock to exit. At the end of the day, once the fire was extinguished, we determined approximately 35 vessels were destroyed. Those vessels ranged in size from somewhere around 20 foot to over 40 foot, houseboats to pontoons. Several people occupied those houseboats as a primary residence. Our first actions were A, to rescue the occupants that were in the water, in addition to extinguishing the fire, rescue the occupants that had jumped off their boats or off the dock and that were in the water. We recovered 7 of those. They were transported to the local hospital, Highlands Medical Center, treated, released, minor injuries or no injuries, mostly just from a hypothermic type condition because of the weather and the water temperature. Multiple boats sunk, some of them at the dock, some of them floated away from the moorings, floated away from the dock and sunk in the lake. We had a quick request from local dive teams and many local agencies, and those dive teams are still working. The immediate effort was to try to account for how many people were on the boats. That proved difficult because the nature of people coming and going off of houseboats and not knowing how many people were staying with who. The original unaccounted number, I guess the number that we felt like was fairly reasonable, was 8 people. At this point, can confirm 8 fatalities. There's no identification for that. That's going to be a process of notification, identification in some cases, and then notification before we can release those individuals' names. I said we originally had 8 unaccounted for. We found 8. I want to be clear, that doesn't mean that our recovery effort is over. We're going to put every resource into ensuring that every vessel and every piece of this lake that we can reasonably suspect is clear. We don't want anybody unaccounted for, and just because we didn't have their name to start with doesn't mean that they weren't out there. So we're going to check every boat and every piece of this as we pull it out with the as best as we possibly can to ensure that. Real quick, just from environmental perspective, that's been a question I've had a couple of times. There is some fuel, there's some plastics, there's that sort of thing that happens with boat fires and boat sinkings. You can see parts of it behind me and all the way around this. We've put containers in place, thanks to our local EMA or state EMA and several others. We don't think any of those contaminants released into the main river channel. We don't think any of those contaminants are near any water intakes or water treatment intakes or anything like that. So we will do everything we can to clean that up. Alabama Department of Environmental Management is going to oversee that cleanup, and I expect that to go be an extensive effort, but they know what they're doing. So again, this is going to take, this is not going to be over today. We're going to be out here for a while. I'd estimate 3 to 4 days, possibly longer, just removing boats, checking boats, and then going to the next one. It's going to be a process. Our primary objective remains to check every boat, every vessel, everything we can check to ensure that we've accounted for all the victims. After that's done, the Alabama State Fire Marshal, in conjunction with Scottsboro Fire Investigators, Scottsboro Police Investigators, the ATF is on scene, and others will begin the investigation into the cause determination of the fire. Finally, I'll say this, and then I'll let you get back to it. We do ask that citizens avoid the area. citizens avoid the lake area where we're at, and that everybody keeps the families, the victims, and our responders in your thoughts. I don't expect that we'll have an update again today in person. I'll be happy to take business cards. If anything comes out on a statement-wise, we can email it. And I appreciate you all coming out, and I appreciate you, again, I appreciate the thoughts, and I appreciate the prayers. So, thank you.
Are you able to say how many of the fatalities were adults and how many were children?
No, I'm not able to comment any further on the fatalities at this point. Again, that identification process is going to take some time, and we want to make sure everybody is notified properly. So I won't do anything that would cause anybody to speculate. Again, I appreciate it. There's about three dozen of you, so I really don't need to take questions. We need to get back to work. Thank you for coming out. And if you want to leave a card, I'll have somebody up here get a card. I can email you any updates or releases as they come out. Thank you.